Howdy everyone, Cub here. Welcome to episode 220 of the Let's Play. And today, guys, we are doing quite a bit, actually. We have a lot of stuff planned for this episode. First and foremost is to go out there and build the Shepherd's House, which we have been meaning to build for the last two episodes now. So I'm just gathering up some stuff here. I think I'm going to go with some dark oak fence. Yeah, dark oak fence gate. Get a couple of chests. And let's see what else. We'll need some stairs, probably. We'll probably need a door, two or three or four. And let's go ahead and head on out there. I want to show you guys exactly the area we're going to build this in. So we'll build the Shepherd's House today, and we'll also build some dog houses, along with some other stuff, potentially, depending on how much time I have. So let's get on out here. First of all, I will take your guys' suggestion, and we're going to separate the Shepherd's House with the sheep and the dog houses. Otherwise, we might have a little bit of an issue here. So the dog houses are going to go here. You see, I've sort of laid this out a little bit. See the sign? Dog houses. And I think we're going to have, some dog houses here. They're going to be kind of small, but yeah, we'll have some fun with it, make some fun stuff, maybe make like a little dog launcher here, perhaps, that goes into this lake. That'd be kind of cool. But let's get on over here to where we're going to build the Shepherd's House. So it's actually on the other side of this fireworks factory over here. And you'll notice, by the way, all the chests are out of Zerzera now, so I'm having to bring over all the materials now instead of running around and getting some from the various chests around here. So we'll make our way over here. So here's the fireworks factory here. And we're going to make our way down this way. And right over here, I've actually sort of started to lay out how I want this house to look. So here's where we're going to build this. And since it is a shepherd's house, I think I'm going to make it mostly out of wood. Or not wood, wool. Well, actually both wool and wood. So I'm going to go ahead and put down this chest here. I'm thinking probably mainly white wool. We might add some color as well, so I brought a bunch of different types of wool. So I'm thinking something like this, like we have the main house here. I want to have sort of a tall roof to this, and then we'll have, maybe like a sheep pen over here, like this whole area here, right next to the fireworks factory would be like a sheep pen of some type. So we'll put down, grass and stuff. And then in the back here, I think it would be cool to have like a little dock area. So, like, the shepherd could come down here and just, like, relax. So I made, like, this little path up here for the shepherd. But, this is sort of the layout here, and let's go ahead and start building. Okay, guys, I think we're going to go with something like this for the shepherd's house. So I think maybe we go with, some spruce wood logs on the bottom, spruce wood on the top, and then something like this with the wool on the sides. I think that would look kind of cool. I think someone suggested in the comments of one of the episodes we make sort of a Viking roof. So we could do something like that, or we could go like up two over one for the majority of this, sort of down the side like that. I think that would be pretty awesome. So I think that's what we're going to do here, actually. Just going to do something like this. So yeah, just have this come, around the side here. And then around the back. And of course, we'll put down the appropriate, places for doors and stuff like that too. Like this would come over just like this. And then we have, a window back here, like a two wide window here, for instance. So we'll leave a little gap there. And then fill in the rest just like that. And then same thing on this side, just continuing this pattern. So I'll continue to build this up here. And I'll be back once we have a sort of a shell of a house up. Okay, guys, so I got sort of the main layout of the first floor done. So let me show you what I got. So this is what I have so far. So the gaps like this is going to be like where windows go. And yeah, same thing with this here. There'll be a door right here. I need to fill in a piece of wool right there. And also right here. So there'll be a door here, door here, door here. So three doors. And yeah, you can see where the windows are going to go. I'm thinking something like this for the floor plan. I'm thinking we have like a wall here. And then a wall here, and I'm probably going to make these, let's say we'll make these out of some light gray, just to be a little bit different. So we'll have like a light gray wall right here, and same thing right here. And so this will be like the bedroom, so I might as well just go ahead and move the bed into here. So plop our bed down right here, and we might as well go ahead and place down our doors too. So I'm thinking probably birch doors would be best. I have door there. Let's see, where's the other one? Door here, except Want it to be on the opposite side, and then door here. So there's our doors right there. Now, I'm thinking this could be like a kitchen area here with some furnaces along the wall. And then this here would have like the family room right here. Bedroom right there, and then we'll have like a second bedroom on the second story. So like maybe we have, you know, like a ladder here going up, because the roof is going to be quite tall. So I think the next step is to just go ahead and make the roof, and we'll see exactly where we're going to put the ladder and everything, and see how much space we have above this to work with. Alright everyone, so I'm up here working on the roof now, and I think I came with a good solution to sort of frame this, and that is stone bricks. So if I just go ahead and get onto the top here, let me just sort of tower up. Let's just get this broken, and yeah, we'll just keep going up like this. And so on the top here, I think what I'll do is I'll just put, yeah, stone bricks surrounding the wood roof. So let me just show you what this looks like here. If I get all the way over here, there we go. I'll go ahead and get down on the front here, and we'll take a look. So this is what it looks like on the front. Not too bad, I don't think. I think it looks pretty good. But the sides is what I really like. These sides here. See, I've sort of inset the wool there, and you can even add like some fence or something up here like this, maybe. Like that. To make it look kind of cool. Maybe put a window in there or something for the second story. But I think it looks pretty good now. It has like a little bit of a Viking feel to it. So yeah, I think I'm going to go with something like this. And then on the second story right there, I think I might put like a little door coming out of the second story. As sort of like a second story balcony area. Because we have an extra block to work with here. So yeah, we'll see. We'll see. So yeah, I'm going to go ahead and keep working here, and I'll be back once I'm done. Alright guys, so we got sort of a Viking roof vibe going on now, just sort of with the same up one over two pattern. You can see the roof is a little bit varied. Looks a little bit strange because I have some stairs in some spots, so it looks like it's maybe eroded in some spots, so it's not, you know, totally uniform. We also outlined it with stone brick, as you can tell here. We made a little design pattern on both sides. We also have some buttons along the bottom now, and I went ahead and swapped out the gray wool, the light gray wool, for some brown wool, because I think it looks a lot better. Looks better, goes better with the interior here. So the bedroom will be right here. We'll have the kitchen here, living room here, and then I went ahead and added this ladder here. Can probably go ahead and get rid of this, since we already know what's going here. But I went ahead and added this ladder here, and this is going to be like the area where you store your hay. So the shepherd's going to store a bunch of hay up here. On this part of the house, and there'll be a door here. They can come out on the roof and then just toss hay bales down to the sheep, which will be in this area right here. So I think it's a pretty good design. I like the jungle wood logs as the roof here. Makes it look really cool. Goes really well with the spruce here. And I might want to put one more of those right there. Yeah. Cool. So yeah, that's what we got so far. So yeah, I'll continue to build up here and decorate the inside. Okay guys, so we went ahead and got the shepherd's house now done. So let's just go ahead and take a little tour of the outside first. So yeah, I'll just sort of go around it here. So this is what it looks like from the front. Obviously you can see we put a spruce door with an iron bar as like a railing up there. So we can, yeah, access the roof from inside the house. Also we got some sheep here, obviously. So these sheep, yeah, they roam in this grassy area here, which is obviously going to be maintained by the shepherd. We also have some hay bales out here that can munch on, and we went with some passive gates here. So these gates we can pass through, but the sheep cannot. So the sheep are all stuck in here, and yeah, they can't get through there, as you can see. So yeah, that's pretty cool. That's the area we keep the sheep in. Let's go ahead and go inside the actual house, now with the decorations and everything. So first of all, looks like a sheep somehow gained access here, and he's having a grand old time. But anyway, we got a joke coming in here. Wool hello there. I'm sorry guys, I had to make that joke. Wool hello there. So yeah, that's the greeting when you come in. You see that. Let's go ahead and start with the bedroom here. So if we come into the bedroom here, you see we got the shepherd's armor here, all white armor. And then just, yeah, I put the pumpkin on there just for effect. Got an ender chest here. You can see some of the stuff I used to make this house in there. Got a painting, torch obviously to light it up, and yeah, bed, flower, crafting table, and tripwire. So that's the bedroom there. Out here is the kitchen, so this is supposed to be like the trash can right here. So yeah, you can just throw stuff against the trap door here, or just put it on here, and then just drop it in. I got a chest here. We have, obviously, the cooked mutton, because it is a shepherd's house, so he'd have, you know, mutton cooking. Yeah, some mutton in here, in the furnaces. And, yeah, this is supposed to be, like, the kitchen area. Over here, we got, like, a main living area, so we got books, we got, yeah, crafting table, chest. And then, yeah, right here is supposed to be, like, the couch. This guy loves dancing. Yellow sheep, dancing queen right there. But yeah, this is supposed to be like the TV right here. So if we turn this on, you can see this is like supposed to be like the channel up, channel down levers here. And we also have some, let's see if I can get up here. We have some daylight sensors on top. That's how these lamps are being powered. And so you can see the scary spider show on the TV. We hit this button. You can hear some scary sounds. So that's like a heartbeat. And that's like dramatic music. But if you step on these pressure plates, or a villager or a sheep steps on the pressure plates, scary music plays. So yeah, it's like dramatic music to go with the spider theme on the quote unquote TV. So yeah, that's pretty cool. Just a little bit of a redstone thing there. In this chest, we got some wool, some wheat, some hay bales, stuff to feed the sheep. We also have a shear right there. This obviously leads back out to the sheep pen here. So that's where that goes. And I did have to terraform all this desert here. So this is all terraformed grass here. Just so the sheep can eat and, yeah, regrow their wool that way. So there's that section there. Let's go ahead and go up to the top here through the trap door. And up here, we got some, obviously some storage for the hay bales. We got some, yeah, acacia sapling. We got some chest action going on. We got, yeah, a crafting table, some cobwebs, because obviously this would be like a dusty area up here. Bench, a bed, and of course we got a place where we can climb on top of the hay bales, just for fun. So that's that, and then this door here leads out to the roof, obviously. So you can just pitch the hay bales over the side and give them to the sheep down there. So that's pretty cool. And then let's see, let's go down once more. Yeah, so that's the top area. Let's go down once more. There's one more section out here. This is the deck section. So I made it out of gray wool. We got a little bench here with a railing. Just a nice overlook of the, actually looking toward the mob farm up there. And yeah, just a nice overlook of the river. Again, I terraformed all this into grass right here. And then, yeah, we can go down here, down to the dock, and, yeah, we got, like, a little dropper thing here, but, yeah, that's it. That's about it, guys. Yeah, private property. No trespassing. Too bad. I'm going in. Anyway, that's the whole thing here, guys. Scary spider. So, yeah, do let me know what you guys think. I think it's a pretty good build, though. I think it turned out really well, and, yeah, props to you guys for suggesting the Viking like roof. I think it turned out really well. So now that we have that done, we gotta just take all the stuff we used to make this, so all this chest and all the stuff in the ender chest, take this back to the base, and then we'll get started on the dog houses. So I'll be back over on the opposite side of the balloon repair shop to work on the dog houses. Okay guys, so we are out here now on the opposite side of the balloon repair station, and we're here with Blaze, our dog. And I think it's time we now go ahead and build some of these dog houses. So these are going to be of all varying sizes and shapes. Some of them will be able to fit just one dog. Some of them will be able to fit multiple. The one we're going to build now, though, is actually suggested by a viewer. And he wanted us to build a bone-shaped dog house. So I've taken the liberty to do that. And we're going to build it right now. So first things first, we're going to take this down. And so I think we're going to build this right here, actually. So let me go ahead and place down some blocks. So we'll go ahead and place a, let's see, we'll go ahead and place a block here and a stair block here. So this is going to be like one of the entrances. And we'll also have an entrance on this back side here. So I'm just going to clear out a little bit of land back here. Just like this. There we go. Okay. Oop, long and dangerous hole there. Don't fall in. Okay, so, yeah, then we're going to take some blocks of quartz here, and we'll come out two blocks on either side, and then we'll come around the back two blocks, and then two blocks on the back here as well, at which point we're going to have two stairs here, and then two blocks here, And then finally, right here, we're going to have two more blocks. So that's going to be the basis of our house here. Now for the floor, I think I'm going to go with just a oak plank floor. This looks actually pretty good with the quartz for a doghouse, I think. So we're going to go ahead and place down some blocks like this. Some blocks like that, and like this. There we go. Let's get rid of that sand. Now, I want to go ahead and place down some fence gates here and right here. That's going to be how we get in and out. And then I want to place some white stained glass all around the outside here, except not right there. So all around the outside here, just like this, like this, like this, and like that. And then we'll get on top here, and we're going to go ahead and place down some varying blocks here. So we're going to place down some slabs on the sides here like this. And then for the middle part, it's going to be a little bit tricky here. We have to, let's see, we want to have it come into the side here. So I think what we want to do is this. We want to have it be like this, and then like this, and have it go around in sort of like a circle shape almost. And then maybe we have full blocks right there. And then on the center here, since we want, on the map, we want it to sort of come in, we're going to have just stairs down like this. So we'll have, let's see, we'll put a stair like that. And then once again here, it'll be stairs like this, and then around like this, around like that, and then two full blocks there and there. And so I actually need a little bit more stair. So let's get some more quartz stairs here. There went the crafting table. Just pick that bad boy back up. And we'll get some more quartz stairs. There we go. Perfect. And so we got a backup here. And we need to place down quartz stairs like that. So that should look like a bone from above. Now I'm going to add some other details in here. So for instance, we're going to add like a little dog bed. So we're going to get some carpets. Place one down there and one down there, let's say. Can also add a dog bowl, so like a food bowl. So we put in something like that. Let's put a hopper on top of this, so like that, and we'll put some dog food in there, just like that. We can also have, you know, a water bowl. So let's just go ahead and put a water bowl, let's say, over here. So the water bowl will be like this. There we go. Perfect. And then, of course, we do need some bones in here for the dogs. So we'll put like one there, and let's put another one, say, right here. That'd be cool. All right, sweet. So there we have it. That's a bone-shaped doghouse. Let's go ahead and take a look at what it looks like on the map. So taking a look at the doghouse from the map, you can see it does indeed look like a bone. So you have the sort of dumbbell ends and then the very narrow part in the center, which is pretty cool, if you ask me. There is one other thing I want to do, though. I want to actually get in here, and I will need to put some light in here. So we're going to go ahead and put some glowstone underneath of the quote-unquote dog beds. So we're going to put glowstone right there, and then also right over here. And then just put the carpet back, and there we go. So yeah, Blaze seems to like it. I'm going to go ahead and get him out of here, and yeah. There we go. That's the first doghouse done, so let's go ahead and build some more. Okay, guys, so we got a bunch of different doghouses now throughout the area. I'll show you these in a second, but right now we're working on the dog launcher house. So you see, we got, yeah, some redstone down here. I think all we need now is a button, so let's just grab that. We're going to put this right there. And then, yeah, you see we got the redstone down here, so basically what happens is, this bottom repeater powers a dust back here, which is going to launch the piston here. And then we just need a slime block on top. And this other repeater here on four ticks, this goes into a block here, and it basically powers a torch tower that goes up here. So there's another torch right there. And then that pushes out the slime blocks, and that'll push the dog into the water. So let's go ahead and test this out now. I think it's ready to go. Just do that, and let's see. We'll go ahead and cover all this stuff up, because we don't need to see that. There we go. Okay. There we go. And we need obsidian here so that this doesn't stick. Perfect. Okay. I also want to get a trap door for this, probably. There we go. That'll work. Or actually, we could get a half slab, too. So we could do something like that. Yeah, so that should work. Although I want to test it out myself as well. So, yeah, let's go ahead and do this. So let's get a button. Place trap door down right there, I think. Place this down here. Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Okay, it worked for us safely. Good. Good. Let's put Blaze in there. For science, of course. Alright, Blaze. Time for you to go, my friend. Alright, get on in there. Get on in there. It's going to be interesting to see what he looks like when he... Yeah, he's on the slime block. It looks a little weird. Okay, here we go. Blaze liftoff in 3, 2, 1. Alright, yeah, perfect. Exactly what we want to see. He's fine. Didn't take any damage at all. Very nice. Okay. And since this is a dog launcher, we will need to do that. Okay, sweet. So there we go. Alright, so our dog launcher house is all set up now. That's pretty awesome. Let's go ahead and... Oh, he's sitting in... Okay, let's have him sit... Well, he'll follow us around. Let's just have him follow us around. So, these are all the dog houses here. So, this is the first one. This is a pretty basic one. Just a one block gap here. As you can see, you can push the dog into the house like this. And then close it. He's in there now. I believe. Get in there. Yeah, he's in there. So, yeah. That's one option there. Option two, this one right here. So this has a 2x2 area, and we can even go ahead and just put like a little bone in there or something. That would be kind of cool. So let's just grab ourselves an item frame, put that there, and we'll put a bone in the back. Boom, just like that. There we go. There's our doghouse number two. Is he still in there? Yeah, get out of there, guy. Here's doghouse number three. This one has built-in lighting, so it has a daylight sensor on top there, you can see. Inverted daylight sensor. And yeah, this is a two high one, so we can actually walk into that one. So that's that one. You saw the bone one. Yeah, it's a pretty nice one here. Blaze likes this one. Yeah, then the launcher house, which I just showed you. This one's a little bit of a small one here. Only dogs can fit into this. So you can, again, tell the dog to sit and then push him in there. This one's a little bit bigger one. This one has space for a couple of dogs. And yeah, there's a bone in here. And yeah, pretty good shelter, actually, for the dogs. This one's an individual dog house here, so you can push the dog back into it. And yeah, there's also a sign there, so you can name the dog or whatever. So that's that one. This one's a pretty big one. This one actually has, you know, a water bowl, has a couple of, food bowls here as well, and a nice bed for the dogs. So you can fit a couple of dogs in here. And so, yeah, you can see, there you go. That's what it looks like, just like that. And then this one you might have seen before. This one, there was a tutorial on a channel I saw on YouTube. And yeah, basically basically has a door here. So, yeah, that's kind of cool, like a little garage door. And you can see there's a little bit of space back here for the dog. So, yeah, those are the dog houses that I'm going to go with. I think they're pretty good. I like them. I think Blaze likes them. And the only thing we need now is more dogs. So I'm actually going to keep Blaze here for now. I'm going to keep Blaze here. I'm going to go ahead and get a bunch of bones. See how many bones we got in here. Do we have any in here? 3. Yeah, we're going to need more than that. So I'm going to grab some bones, and we're going to go ahead and search for some dogs. I think a good spot to start searching would be to the north, the snow biome to the north, where the old zombie grinder is. So I'm going to head out that way and see if we can find some dogs and bring them back here to populate these dog houses. Alright guys, so I went ahead and bred up some dogs. I actually had to go get the dog from the end of my end line and bring that dog back to breed with Blaze. And so we're going to name some of these dogs here. I'm going to name this guy Loki. right there. The black collar. We're going to name this person or this dog here the red collar Victor. Right there. We'll go ahead and name this dog here with the green collar Lily. There we go. And the pink collar right here, we'll name this dog Abby. And then we'll name this dog here with the cyan collar Sam. There we go. And I think we'll go ahead and name some of the other dogs as well. We'll give them all different unique collar colors. Make sure I got all of them here. Yeah, there we go. That one. Put a blue one here. Magenta can go. Let's see. I think that's almost all of them. Blaze has a yellow one still. Here we go. This one here. Magenta. There we go. All right, cool. So yeah, we now we got a bunch of dogs with a bunch of different collar types, and we're going to put them all into these these houses here. Okay, guys, so we got all the dogs in their houses now. So we got the magenta color dog in there. We got Loki right in here. We have Lily in this one right there. Let's see. We got, I think, Blaze and Abby in this one here. And then we got Sam over here in this small one. We got the lime green colored dog there. Orange colored dog right there. I think we got Victor and the blue colored dog right there. And the light blue colored dog in the modern house. So I'll probably add some more dogs here. And yeah, name the ones that I haven't already named. So if you guys have any suggestions for names, do let me know. And the only other thing I want to do with this episode, guys, is go ahead and take down the wireless teleporter. Because, yeah, I haven't really used it too much recently, so if I don't use it, I might as well just go ahead and take it down. So we'll just go ahead and start to take down stuff here, take down all these sea lanterns and such. And, yeah, I'll be back once we are done clearing this, and we will put something here for 1.9, so that's part of the reason why I'm clearing this. I got some big plans for this area. So I'll be back once I'm done clearing this. Alright guys, so there we go. The wireless teleporter is now gone. Luckily we still have our wired jumper teleporter, which does work and will work in 1.9. But yeah, if there's another way to wirelessly teleport discovered, I will probably build that. So yeah, we'll see about that. Anyway guys, now it's time to head down to the mineshaft and we will see who today's highlighted channel is. So today's highlighted channel is Oscar Osice. I hope that's how you say that. But anyway, Oscar last time left a comment that said, go ahead and build the doghouse as a bone. And that's what we did this episode. We made a doghouse in the shape of a bone. So thank you, Oscar, for the suggestion. This is your mineshaft. Let's see how you do against the other competitors. Alright, and from Oscar's mineshaft, we got the following resources. So we got 22 diamonds, which we mined out with the Fortune 3 pick over here. And yeah, 22 diamonds, quite a bit today. So yeah, good mineshaft today. So here's the updated map of Zerzera, and you can see the shepherd's house we got done today right up here. This little green patch right there. And also the doghouses down here. So there's the bone doghouse right under my cursor. And there's some of the other ones around there, as you can see. Also, you can see the patch balloon we did last time and the fire in this balloon. And with these doghouses being done now, that is it for the brown section. So this section to the right of this road right here. So this section here is now done. And we'll be moving on to a new section next time. So Zerzera is coming together slowly but surely, guys. And that's it for me today. Thank you so much for watching. This has been Cub. Goodbye.